Hello, my dear students. In this video, I am going to teach you the solution of simultaneous linear equations by matrix method. We want to solve simultaneous equation by matrix method. So, how to solve it? Say this is the equation 6x plus 2y equals 7. 10x minus 14y equals 3. How to solve it? Solution. See here. 6 to 12 minus 14, these are the coefficients. We will write down the coefficients matrix denoted by A. So here A is 6, 10 x coefficients, y coefficients 2 minus 14. Then x symbol is denoted by x represents x and y, and d represents right side constants, that is 7. That is the statement. Write down the coefficients. A is a coefficient matrix for x and y. X represents xy to be fine, to be found. D, right side for the constants. A for coefficients of xy, x for xy to be determined, and d for the right side, that is the 7 and 3 here. Now how to find it? Its identity is A inverse D equals x. Identity to be used is x equals A inverse D. Now see here, D we know, it's given 7, 3. X we know represents variables to be determined. We have to go for A inverse. How we can go for A inverse? That is A equals 6 to 10 minus 14. Inverse is 1 by A determinant adjoint A. A inverse is 1 by A determinant adjoint A. It means first you are supposed to find A determinant. A determinant will come out to be minus 84 minus 20. Then it will be minus 104. For adjoint A, we can write directly it is 2 by 2. Adjoint A will come out to be interchange. The principal diagonal entries which I have explained already, minus 14, 6. Change the sign of the entries along the secondary diagonal, minus 10, minus 2. Interchange and change the sign. See, the concept I have used here is interchange the principal diagonal entries, change the sign along the secondary diagonal. So that will give you the adjoint. Thus A inverse will come out to be 1 by A determinant adjoint A. Thus A inverse equals A inverse equals 1 by A determinant adjoint it. A inverse equals A determinant minus 104 adjoint A minus 14 minus 10 minus 2 and 6. So like that we can find A inverse. Now use the identity x equals A inverse B. X for x y A inverse one by minus 1 by 104 minus 14 minus 10 minus 2 6. So that will come out to be A inverse. Then D for 7 3. So like that you will get. Then solve it. XY matrix minus 1 by 104 multiply the 2 minus 14 into 7 minus 98 minus 6 minus 70 minus 10 into 7 plus 18. So like that you can multiply. It will come to be xy equals minus 1 by 104 minus 104 50 minus 52 xy equals minus minus plus 2 plus 1 by 2. By multiplying, this is what we will get. Therefore, x equals 2 and y equals 1 by 2. So that is the solution of this equation. See once again, write it in the matrices, coefficient matrix, x for the variables xy, d for the constant rate segment. Then identity to be used is x equals a inverse t. Go for a inverse, multiply it by d and equate the two matrices. That is how we can do 2 by 2 matrices. Solve by matrix method. X minus 2 equals minus 2y 2x plus 3y equals 3. Solution: x transpose y term to the left side plus 2y minus minus 2 to the right side plus 2. 2x plus 3y equals 3. So as to make the like terms together. After this, we can write A matrix of coefficients 1, 2, 3, 2. X as x, y variables to be determined. D for 2, 3, that is our HS. We have to use that empty. X equals A inverse D. So A inverse is required. Adjoint A, interchange the elements in the principal diagonal, change the sign of the secondary diagonal. Thus, and go for A determinant also. A determinant will come out to be 2 minus 6 minus 4. So therefore, A inverse equals 1 by A determinant adjoint A. A inverse determinant of A is minus 4, adjoint is 2 minus 2 minus 3, 1. You see here A is 1, 2, it should be 2, 3. 2 and 3 have done this mistake. X, Y, D, 2, 3. Then for A inverse D, adjoint A. Change it by changing 3, 1. By changing the sign minus 2, minus 2. Like that, you will get adjoint. Then A determinant will come to be 3 minus 4 minus 1. A inverse will come to be minus 1, and then adjoint is 3, 1, see here. Repeating it, one mistake I have done. Transpose, you will get plus 2 by n plus 2. A will come out to be 1, 2, 2, 3. X is for x, y, d is for 2, 3. Here I have written 3, 2 in the previous, so please take it. Be careful, here it is 2, 3. X and then d. X equals A inverse d. Now come to A inverse d. So first we need adjoint A. Adjoint A will be interchange principal diagonal entries and change the sign So that will be a joint A. A determinant will come out to be 3 minus 4 minus 1. So use that and T. X equals A inverse T. We need A inverse. So to find A inverse, 1 by A determinant adjoint A. 1 by A determinant. A determinant is minus 1. Adjoint A. That is 3 minus 2 minus 2, 1. Thus it equals minus 3 plus 2 plus 2 minus 1. That will be A inverse. After finding A inverse, use that and T x equals A inverse B. So put the values. So use that and T x equals A inverse B. X bar x y. A inverse. A inverse is minus 3, 2, 2 and minus 1. XY A inverse D. Then D is for 2, 3. Now multiply the 2, minus 6, plus 6, minus 6 plus 6, 4, minus 3, so thus XY will come out to be 0 and 1. Therefore, x is 0, y is 1. Solve by matrix method. X minus y plus z equals 4. So rearrange the terms if required. X, X, X terms, Y, Y, Y terms, Z, Z, Z terms, it should be like that. Here, we will get A. Matrix equals 1, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 3, 1. X bar. Now there are three variables. X bar, x, y, z. D for 4, 0, 2. We have to use our IT. A inverse D equals X. Overall, we have to find A inverse. See how you will find A inverse. A inverse equals, see it carefully. Cofactor of the elements. Cofactor of the elements, then transpose. Or we can take the cofactor of the elements. Cofactor of 1. Cut row, cut column, 1 minus 3, 1, 1. Determinant of 1 minus 3, 1, 1. With a positive sign. I mean same sign you can say. Then add negative sign. Cut the row, cut the column. 2 minus 3, 1, 1. 2 minus 3, 1, 1. Then same sign. That is positive sign. One. Cut the row, cut the column. 2, 1, 1, 1. CK free, like that you are supposed to write. See, once again I am repeating this row. Same sign, or you can say put positive sign, add positive sign, which means the same sign. Cut this row, cut this column, 1 minus 3, 1, 1. Second one, plus and minus, then put here negative sign. We are not supposed to consider the sign of the entries. We are simply putting a positive, negative like that. For this, cut the row, cut the column, 2 minus 3, 1, 1. 2 minus 3, 1, 1. That will be the cofactor. For cofactor of 3, cut the row, cut the column, plus minus plus sign positive. By cutting row and column, we will get 2, 1 and 1, 1. 2, 1 and 1. Like that, you have to write for all the elements. CF, plus, minus, plus, you have to put negative sign. For 2, cut the row, cut the column, minus 1, 1, 1, 1. Minus 1, 1, 1, 1. For 1, plus, minus, plus, minus, then same sign or the positive sign. Cut this row, cut this row, cut this column. 1, 1, 1, 1. See it once again for this 1. Cut this row, cut this column. We are with 1, 1, 1, 1. Negative sign. Signs are alternative. So put alternate signs for this now. Cut the row, cut the column. 1 minus 1, 1, 1. For this 3 it is, cut the row, cut the column. 1 minus 1, 1, 1. Here, for this 1, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. Means the same sign now. Cut the row, cut the column. Minus 1, 1, 1, 3. Negative sign means we have to change the sign. Cut the row, cut the column. See, cut the row, cut the column. 1, 1, 2, minus 3. Plus means the same sign. One. cut the row, cut the column. 1 minus 1, 2, 1. So like that you will get it. So after solving, we will get 4 minus 5. Just open the determinants, 1 minus minus plus 3. So this is what you will get. Now we this is the adjoint, or this is the cofactor. Take the transpose for the adjoint. So by taking transpose, we will get adjoint A equals A inverse T. Here it is adjoint A. Adjoint A is this. By solving, we will get adjoint as 4 minus 5, 1, 2, 0, minus 2, then 2, 5, 3. Like that, we will get adjoint. Then for A inverse, 1 by A determinant, adjoint A. So it means we are supposed to find A determinant. A determinant. So solve it. A determinant will come out to be 1. Cut the row, cut the column. Cut the row, cut the column. We'll get right here better first determinant. 1 minus 3, 1, 1. 1 minus 3, 1, 1. Minus 1, minus 1, element, 1 negative sign we have to add. So you can write it as minus 1, then again minus 1. Minus 1. And again, minus 1. For 1, this is the determinant. For minus 1, put here negative sign. Then negative. Negative sign for the element. Cut the row, cut the column. 2 minus 3, 1, 1. Then plus. Element is plus 1. Like that here, minus, then element is minus 1. Then cut the row, cut the column. 2, 1, 1, 1, which will give us 1 plus 3, minus, minus, plus, 2 plus 3.
The value of this determinant will come out to be.
Now see here, 1 plus 3, 4. This here it should be 4. 4, 5, 1. So it will come out to be 10. Value of A determinant is 10. then use that empty A inverse. 1 by A determinant adjoint A. 1 by 10 adjoint A. 4 minus 5, 1, 2, 0, minus 2, 2, 5, 3, the inverse. So therefore, use that empty x equals A inverse B, that is x bar xyz, A inverse bar 1 by 10 of 4 minus 5 1 2 0 minus 2 2 5 3 D for D is for A is there 402 402 So now we have to solve this one. X, Y, Z equals 1/10 of -20, 0, 10 4, 0, 6 X, Y, Z 1/10 of 20 minus 10 and 10. X, Y, Z 2 minus 1, 1. Therefore, x is 2, y is minus 1, z is 1. X is 2, y is minus 1, and z is 1. That is how we can solve linear equations by matrix. So I hope you have got it nicely. If you are getting it nicely, try it at home until and unless you will not try each and every step. You have to write. You can't read math. Write it, compare it, and get it. If you feel I am serving you people, kindly subscribe my channel. Put the icon bell so as to get the next uploads. So I am trying to solve whole of the syllabus on the YouTube where you can get freely. No tuition is required if you can do it nicely at home. So please, my request is do not go for tuitions. Learn it from here. If any problem comes, my WhatsApp number is 9886492317 So you can call there. I will solve your problems. So kindly subscribe and press the icon bell. That's it today. So while solving the previous sum of 3 by 3, at this point I have done the mistake. I am highlighting that. Here I have written 3 instead of 1. It's 1, 0, minus 1 and 1, not 3. Here I have put by mistake 3. By mistake, I have written 3. So put here 1 and solve it. When you will solve it with 1, so it will come out to be minus 7, minus 8, 6, and 4. Please change those entries. When you will solve it, it will come out to be 2, 21, minus 18, 6, minus 7, 6, 8, 4, minus 8, and then 4. So please make the necessary correction only.